Greetings, sports fans, ASMR Sports. Right back with you today. We've got some 2022 Prizm Draft basketball. Boy, it's having a hard time focusing, isn't it? I also got some new... Wow, that is cruel. Got some new bubble gum. That is substantially... was a lot softer when I ate it like a couple days ago, and that was probably when I just opened the bag, so maybe it dries out really quickly. That's a bummer. I guess that's why they sell it in like you know, those plastic tubs that you can like put the lid on. Alright. Well, I thought I would take a second and look with you all at the stat over here for the 2022 draft class. I'm not sure if you can see these. Probably not. I think I can zoom in here. Well, no, it won't let me zoom in on the so let me just say, oops. Paolo Banchero is certainly the leader of this group. He's got 20 points per game. He's averaging 33.8 minutes per game up in Orlando there, so down in Orlando. So seems to be getting his playing time. Benedict Mathurin is... out of him in games played 67 and averaging 27.8 minutes with 16.6 points per game, so he's actually looking pretty solid, it looks like. Jaden Ivey has 15.4 points per game, Jaden Williams 13.4, Jabari Smith 12.2, Keegan Murray 11 points, and so yeah. Paolo Banchero is definitely the standout. But he was the number one draft pick, so you would imagine that's sort of logical. And on like the defensive side, Jalen Duren, who is down here averaging 8.6 points per game, has got 8.8 rebounds per game, leading the rookie class here. So, yeah, I don't know what to draw from all this, but, and then Chet Holmgren is injured, of course. He was the number two draft pick. Probably someone, you know, you wouldn't mind pulling some decent cards of. Honestly, I normally wouldn't buy this stuff, but I don't know, for whatever reason, I went to Target and, I don't know, the orange box caught my eye. So I was like, oh, let me check that out, because it was the first time I'd seen this stuff there. These boxes are $29.99, as are most blaster boxes from Panini these days. So it's definitely not a good deal. It's really hard to get value out of these. At least this format of this stuff, I think you can get a hobby box of this stuff for like, you know, a bit over $100, like $120 maybe. And from what I've seen, those are a decent value, you know, if you're into this particular draft class, or you believe they're, you know, they've got some potential. But of course, there's always potential. Here we got Julius Randle. Ryan Rollins. Our green prism is Dalen Terry. There's a Devin Booker throwback. And Ousmane Dieng. Okay, so that was pretty lackluster. himself a nice year, so not a terrible pick. I'll probably pull that out for sleeving. Ben Watson, and there's Chet Holmgren. So he's one of those like super tall, super lanky dudes. Played for Gonzaga and was a high school, you know, superstar, and you know, seems to move pretty well for someone who's like 7 feet plus. So be interested to see if he holds up in the NBA. I mean, he's certainly beefed up since his high school days when he really looked like a stick, but NBA is another level of physicality. Notwithstanding that it was like way more physical in the 80s, 70s, and 80s. Tyson Daniels, Jalen Williams. So, one of the better performing guys in the class showing up there. Devin Booker, brilliance. Insert, well, black and white for Clyde Drexler with Houston. And Ochai Agbaji. So, let's see. I think there was three packs and we had three left. Yeah, so six packs and five cards per pack. Man, Russell Westbrook looks like totally different back when he was in college, doesn't he? Jalen Williams. One of the better performers. Jabari Smith Jr., another top, you know, five pick who is doing not too bad for Houston. That's a green, not numbered, of course. So not a bad pick there. Not a bad pull. Jimmy Buckets and Jaden Hardy. Two more packs. Looking for that Paolo. Okay, we got AJ Griffin. Dominique, another purple. Allen Iverson throwback. We'll take that out, why not? Paul George and Jabari Walker. The other Jabari. See that coming. I don't know how common autos are and this stuff, but I would assume not very. Alright, I had to clear my throat there. I don't know if it'll say here. If you can even see that through the. Let's get the one that doesn't have plastic on it, shall we? Says, you know, they're in there. I feel like this camera is kind of not as clear as I'd like, so I'm gonna clean that up real quick. Alright, well, let's look it up. Colin Welp, University of California, Irvine. No idea who this guy is. This is not numbered. This is not a, just a green parallel penmanship. Colin Welp. I'm gonna look him up. I'm gonna see what he's up to. Is he still in college? Is it possible? I mean, I guess that is possible these days for them to, like, kind of put, you know, college players and non-college players in the same part. I guess they could always, well, was possible to do that before, you know, they changed the law, or there was a case that basically said that, you know, professional athletes have to be, just see what I'm looking at, here's the stats, professional athletes, you know, have to be paid for, or can be paid for their, name, image, and likeness rights. I don't know. Well, this says 2021, 22 is, you know, that presumably was his last year of college. So, weird. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I guess this guy just was not drafted, right? Let's see what their news. No, no news. So, okay, yeah, these are all UCI stats. Horizontally, when they have a horizontal card, I'm not sure if I've seen that, or at least I've not noticed it. I remember the 2020 Prizm LeBron James was a horizontal card, but I actually don't know what the back of that looks like off the top of my head. So, Walker Kessler doing all right for the Jazz this year. Paul Pierce throwback. Williams and Keith. else's are parallel. Devin Booker base and another Ousmane Ding. Look, we got a bunch of doubles in that one. Another Shaq, another Anthony Davis, a purple Scottie Pippen. I don't think he's any good, but I'll take that out. Peyton Watson, and another Chet Holmgren base. So I guess if you're gonna get doubles, you might as well get the one of the top guys. Kind of makes me think we're gonna get a bunch of doubles in this one too. So just a green here to end things off. Dyson Daniels, Jalen Williams, and another autograph. Interesting. I kind of wonder if it's sort of one autograph per box. I know it's not advertised, right? They don't really ever do that. That's one purple. Wave per box, but yeah, definitely not guaranteed. There's very few products that guarantee, although the one product they do guarantee is whatchamacallit, I can't think of it now. So he's playing in the European League. He played for Howard University and the Huskies, which is the team that he's depicted in his card. So at least he's playing professional basketball. So I got that. All right, Clyde Drexler and Ochai Agbaji on the last card. So, yeah, I mean... value in this rip for me, just because I really haven't opened. I've owned a lot of draft stuff over the years, various products from different brands, but I've not really opened too much of it. So it is interesting to see this stuff from time to time. But yeah, not a lot of potential upside. I mean, if you got like one of those purple shimmers of a Paolo Banchero or Chet Holmgren, you might say you have some value, maybe down the line. If either of those guys kind of catches fire. But other than that, in retail, I don't know that you can, get much that has really any value. The autographs are certainly interesting to see two of them come out of two boxes. I actually have a third box I'm not going to open, but at least not here. I might open it on my other channel, The Sports Card Show. But it'd be interesting to see if there's an autograph in that one. Maybe they just got all their autographs of guys who, are in the European League or the G League or aren't playing professionally, and they put them in retail products. I don't know. That is something that, they do from time to time or all the time. I don't know. I would definitely, if you're a basketball fan, you're excited about one or more players in this 22 class, and, you don't mind kind of spending $30 on some entertainment, I would say go for one of these boxes. Other than that, I probably would not recommend this stuff to anybody. Although, I would definitely, if I had it, if it was easy to get, I suppose everything's easy to get. one sense, but if it were something, my distributor had sent me or something like that, and I'm speaking of now of because I'm not really that interested in it. But if I had it, you know, and it was just sort of a matter of losing the money that I paid for it, I would probably open it, but I don't, so sticking with these retail jobs. But well, that's what we got for today, folks. I hope everybody's doing well. Thanks so much for watching. Please give a like and subscribe and head on over to the Sports Card Show, my other channel, link in the description. If you want to subscribe there for some non-ASMR sports card content, I'm trying to get some videos up there, so hopefully I'll keep that rocking. All right, everybody, you guys have a great one. We'll catch you later. Bye now.